in the bayou and I need transportation.
Just gonna take a squirt, then I'll get her out to you.
He's gonna kill me.
Got a car here for you.
That's a big help.
Itty-bitty moccasin scare you, boy?
They ain't creeping and crawling all up on you.
Just keep your eyes peeled in case this Alvarez guy legs out in this direction.
In English. See? I killed the men outside. I only want to talk to you, so I'm gonna put my gun down, all right?
If you try and fuck me, I kill you!
Fair enough.
You're the one who wants to kill me!
I wasn't trying to kill you, I was trying to find you. Your uncle, he sold you out. He ain't coming to get you.
You're lying. I just spoke to him. He said he was sending a boat.
Wait, you think it's a coincidence that as soon as you got here, those greaseballs showed up? Zaraga called Marcano, told him where to find you.
I must find a phone.
Jesus, man, there's no one for you to call. Marcano is never gonna let you out of this city. He's gonna use you, and when he gets what he wants, he's gonna kill you. The only shot of getting out of this alive is me.
What do you want from me?
Tell me where Marcano's counterfeit operation is set up and we're square.
Everything is in a boxing ring that Tony Marcano owns, but it's already up and running.
Okay, that's all I need to know. Come on. It's time we got the hell out of here.
Where are you taking me?
I know someone who can get you out of the city. Make sure Marcano doesn't find you.
Yeah.
If you want to live through this, stick close to me. You understand?
As I walk along, I wonder what went wrong with our
love. We need to get to my car.
I can get us.
So no. We take mine.
If it'll get you out of here, sure. Just keep your head down.
We've done together.
mierda! ¡Que todos se mueran en un incendio, coño!
That was the last of them, I think.
Yeah, well, keep an eye out anyway.
He could have killed me. Put a bullet in my head and still fuck Marcano.
You got a question in there somewhere?
Yeah. Why didn't you?
Just didn't sit right. Look, you didn't do anything to me. As far as I can tell, you're just another person in the long line of folks Marcano's fucked over. Sometimes it's as simple as that.
Okay. Thank you.
The more kids you have, the more money you'll save. Every Tuesday of the Briar Patch, kids eat free. Whether you have 2 or 10, we'll feed the whole brood. Ask your server for details. Restrictions may apply. The Briar Patch. Good food. Good folks. Good old-fashioned Southern hospitality.
Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. This Sunday, Stoltz Beer brings hot rods and funny cars to Baton Rouge. Come see the action at the Smokin' Dixie Speedway. Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. 180 mile an hour top fuel dragsters. Top fuel funny cars. Factory hot rods. Get your tickets now and see Crash-O-Rama. Demolition's early to the dead. It's the wildest show on wheels. Fun for the whole family.
Thank you. Langan? What's going on?
I need your help getting this man out of the city. He's in a lot of trouble with Sal Marcano.
I don't...
Hit the lepers. This who you told me about?
Yeah, he's the one. Listen, Father, I'm really counting on you here. I got nowhere else I can take him.
Shit, I'm... All right. I know a Jesuit in New Mexico. He helps people in situations like this.
What needs to happen right now? Marcano's gonna tear the city apart looking for him.
All right, I'll make the call. Pasa, por favor. Aquí estás a salvo.
Gracias.
I appreciate this.
Send a new ride to the French ward.
No can do, lad. Sorry.
Can you get me a new ride in the French ward?
Just gonna take a squirt, and I'll get her out to you.
Set of Hot Wheels, just like you ordered.
That's a big help.
How y'all doing? Got a good show for y'all. So just stop trying to adjust your radio. It ain't broke. Back half of the program, we'll be playing some fine music you're gonna dig. But before we get there, let's flip over to the other side of the world. Vietnam. God damn. Vietnam. The Vietnam War rages on. Talking about the black men killed there. But I tell you what, New Bordeaux, don't fucking kid yourself. Ain't just about black men, is it? Hell no. Plenty of death to go round to the poor folk, too. You ain't got shit. And son, you get shit on. Meanwhile, the politicians glad hand the widows and orphans. Give speeches about the nobility of war. Saying the battlefield is where the warrior should meet his end. As if they had any fucking clue. And you know what I say to them? Go fuck yourself. The nobility in dying with your face down in Vietnamese mud. It doesn't fucking exist. Now we told by the white news.
What's up, buttercup? I got a lineup.
Tommy Marcano brought in a counterfeiter from Cuba, right?
Well, Sal spent a couple of months trying to print the money himself, but none of it was worth a damn. The color was wrong, printing was cockeyed, you name it. He needed someone who knew what the fuck they were doing. So he used his connections and found a man named Alvarez.
And this Alvarez was also counterfeiting money for Castro.
Most of our enemies counterfeit American money. Hell, some of our allies do too.
Sorry, he's gone.
What do you mean, he's gone? All you had to do is drive down to the goddamn lighthouse and pick him up.
It's not my fault Alvarez is running all over the goddamn place. I wanted to lock his ass up, but you wouldn't hear of it. The last thing we need is Zaraga finding out that we treated his nephew like dog shit. You understand? Then Lincoln Clay comes in shooting the shit out of it.
Lincoln Clay. Lincoln Clay. I'm so sick and fucking tired of hearing about this cocksucker. He's just one man. A fucking nigga. We're skating a thin line here, Tommy, you understand? This thing falls apart, we fucked all of us.
So, what the fuck would you do?
What the fuck would I do? Listen here, this ain't rocket science. If that fucking nigga got to Alvarez, it means he knows about the place. He's gonna come after him, you understand? Get Get your ass down to that motherfucking gym and protect them.
Yeah, sure. I'm on it.
This shit ends right here, right now. No more fuck-ups.
Fuck me.
According to these reports, Tommy Marcano had the money press in a boxing gym he operated.
Tommy knew Lincoln was coming for the plates, but he felt he had to keep up appearances. The second he started canceling fights and shutting the place down was the second people started thinking he was out of his league. He wasn't about to allow that to happen.
How did Lincoln Clay gain access to the gym?
He had me track down a man named Alcee Bennett. Alcee is a small-time hustler that worked for Sammy until he double-crossed him and was kicked out of the Hollow. After that, he scratched out a living recruiting fighters for Tommy's jungle fights. If he vouched for Lincoln at the door, Lincoln could get in without a big ruckus.
Alcee's by the Briar Patch, not far from here. I'll stop by and say hello, see how he's getting along. Have fun.
And I remember how some of these so-and-sos with some money in their pockets tried to treat me and mine way back when.
Breaking New Bordeaux News. There are reports that a fierce gun battle took place earlier today at the Anderson Bay Lot House in the Bayou. Witnesses report extended gunfire, and police are investigating casualties. Police have announced that an investigation is underway.
Well, fuck me running. If it ain't Lincoln Clay.
Surprised to see me, Alcee?
I heard about Sammy and Ellis. Tough break. I guess you made it out okay.
Speak of them once more, and I'll slice you from ear to asshole. Let's go. I'm taking a drive.
Assuming I don't have a choice here.
What do you think?
Lead the way. I ain't stepped foot in the Hollow since November of 62. Almost 6 years.
I know.
Can you at least tell me where we're going?
The Acadia. It's where Tommy Marcano holds his jungle fights, right?
It is.
And you've been recruiting black fighters for him?
I have.
Good. Because I want in.
I ain't gonna question your driving, but you might want to pay attention.
Good. Because I want in.
What? Why?
I wanted you to know. I'd have told you.
If I'm sticking my ass out like that, I need to know why.
Motherfucker, you lucky to be alive after what you did to Sammy. You really think he wouldn't notice you stealing all that money?
Look, I paid for that 100 times over. 6 years banished from the only place I ever called home. Christ. I couldn't even go see my mama on her deathbed.
You made your choice. And now it's time to make another one.
And I do this.
You get a clean slate. Come and go through the hollow as you please.
Fuck. Okay.
I hear if you win out, Tommy meets you in person. That true?
He likes the size of the winners. See if there's someone he wants to bring on regular. Or if they're just a one-time deal.
Where's this happen?
Usually up there in his office. One of his guys will meet you in the locker room after the fight. He'll take you to Tommy.
All right.
Fighters don't take the front entrance. We go in through the side door.
See, who the fuck's this?
This is Jackknife Johnson.
What's he here for?
Fuck you mean, what he here for? We here to fight, boy.
Gotta search him. No weapons allowed.
Do what you gotta do. Watch where you put your hands, motherfucker.
Save it for the ring, dipshit. Go ahead.
Locker room's down here on the hill.
Hang back, boys.
Motherfucker needs a doctor.
Just dump him in an alley. Let nature take its call.
You good now. Go on.
How you, Neville?
Where you at, LC?
All right. I gotta go make the arrangements. Give him your name and such. You go on and get changed.
Who you got with you tonight, Elsie?
New guy.
Man, new guy looks tough, but my money's staying on the brawler.
I gotta ask you something, Elsie.
What's that?
Do all you niggas love beating the fuck out of each other?
So what happens if we get caught?
Probably what you think.
For a chance to go home again, it's worth it. No matter what happens, we should go. This is it. You nervous?
Should I be?
Guess that depends on where all this ends. You're gonna head through these doors and they announce your name. Then make your way to your corner.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'll meet you there. This part of the show is all about you. They love showing off their fighting niggas.
Get in there, meat.
And the jungle fight continue, boys! Challenger to face Nick Boom Boom Beaumont comes in at over 6 feet tall, weighing approximately 220 pounds. This is Jackknife Johnson!
Y'all can kiss my black ass!
Motherfuckers over here!
We have our winner! In the white corner, Jackknife Johnson!
That's it! Show me the love!
You gotta keep moving and don't let him get you in the corner.
Stay out of the corner. Got it.
Yeah! You love this, don't you?
Making his way to the ring is the Beast of the Bayou, the Rampage of Riverall, your champion, Clay Diggamon!
You know why they call him Grave Digger?
Because he buries motherfuckers?
Well, yeah.
So how do I beat him?
You hit him really, really hard.
Hit him harder.
That's it, kid. Let's go.
What happens now?
You head on back to the locker room and collect your winnings.
Where are you heading?
Me? I got business to attend to.
Few niggas really know how to brawl. My respect, that's for fucking sure.
You must think I'm some kind of goddamn moron coming in here like you did.
I've never been one to shy away from a calculated risk.
Maybe you should have. I'll mix some vegetable oil in. Makes the gasoline thick. Sticky. We're just gonna let it soak in a little bit. Work his way into every nook and cranny. That way when I light it, that shit's gonna burn like napalm.
And you. You are gonna hurt like no one's hurt before.
Fuck you.
Guess you ready to die.
You still be conscious as the flames creep up your legs. But as they burn, you be hit in the gut with a sickening revelation. Before you die, you gonna feel your peck of burn. It's gonna curl and twist.
Big mistake, asshole! Run, Randy, run!
We don't have to do this. We can work something out.
So that's that, then.
Sure looks that way.
You know, Sal wanted me to go to law school. Work for some big company. Maybe run for office. Do something decent with your goddamn life, you understand?
Should've listened to him.
It's in the blood, you know.
Yeah. You are who you are. No point in arguing with yourself about it.
Fuck you.
Don't let me boy. Please.
Don't worry. Lou and Sal will be along shortly.
No, no,
we got a
no.
problem.
There, get him!
Burn on that piece of shit!
This is mine!
We got a problem.
Spotted him! This way!
I'm boxed in! Help me out here!
Heroes are great for target practice!
Run up a club!
I'm gonna fillet you!
Motherfucker.
Got it.
Cracking out.
Gonna rip
through.
Gonna cut you a bloody grin.
Shit.
Run for cover.
Cover me while I reload.
Lost another one.
bad piece of shit.
Run, run, run! Get behind something!
I'll piss off you.
Keep your head down! Damn, get him! All units, negative visual on suspect. Begin search and
What happened to the money plates that Sal Marcano stole from the Federal Reserve?
I don't recall.
Georgie! Get your ass in here. Your Uncle Tommy's dead. I thought you'd like to know.
Sorry, Pops. I know what he meant to you. And...
He was a smart kid, your Uncle Tommy. Could have been anything. I tried to tell him, go to college. Even offered to pay for it. Instead, he went to Cuba.
It's not your fault.
Yeah. Well, we're pretty well fucked now, you understand? And I was counting on that counterfeit money without it. Hell.
Well, now there's gotta be something we can do. You go put the squeeze on people. Get to increase what they're kicking up.
It ain't gonna be enough. Just because you poke holes in someone doesn't mean you're gonna get anything extra out of them.
You could always call Leo Galante, ask him to front...
Fuck him! The whole reason I'm building this goddamn casino is to get out from under them worthless fucks. Not bringing the commission, they're gonna want to cut everything. God damn it. Go on, get the hell out of here. I gotta make a call. Get out! Shit. Leo! How the fuck are you? It's Sal. Yeah? Listen, I got something I need to discuss.
I tried to reconcile the part of me that helped Lincoln with the part of me that vowed to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ. But I can't. You know what I remember? I remember watching the news and learning they'd gunned down Dr. King. I remember watching people lash out, riot, because that's all they had left. All the while, Lincoln's in the other room, barely clinging to life. Maybe that's why I did what I did.
South Downs belongs to us. Tommy was smart and set up some solid, low-key rackets there. Should be a smooth transition for us.
Took care of securing this part of the city for you. The boys are looking forward to making their sales at home as soon as possible.
Way I see it, you still owe me for my last little sit-down. I locked down both those fucking rackets, and then you go and take it away. I was wrong any way you slice it. Now's your chance to make it right.
Whoever you call to lock down the auction is up to you, and I respect that. But now, you're talking long-term responsibility. You trusted me with the last piece of the city. No reason to not trust me with this one as well.
You know I'm the only one who will really have your back.
The Haitians will run this part of the city.
Motherfucker, I was running vice rackets when you were still shitting your diapers. Fuck this!
I know you didn't just question me getting this district. Motherfucker, you better watch yourself.
If I stay here any longer, my head's gonna fucking explode.
We'll talk later. Get on out of here. Big Jim?
Detective Jim McCormick.
All right, Detective. I heard you have a problem with Marcano's drug operation in the French Ward.
Boy, it's this whole city's problem. His man Doc Gaston's burrowed down like a fucking cockroach, pumping the whole city full of poison.
Where's Doc Gaston operate out of?
If I knew that, I'd have him in a cell. Biggest goddamn pusher in the city, and no one knows a fucking thing.
The name Sal Marcano tends to do that to people.
Fuck Sal Marcano. Best lead I've got is that one of Gaston's suppliers is coming to town. Gonna meet with one of Gaston's people. I can't get any closer, but your friend says you're good at getting info people.
I'll see what I can find out.
Don't be shy about knocking around some of Doc Gaston's boys. Probably the only way to get him to talk.
My mama ain't doing too good. Doctor.
It's trouble you don't want, boy.
Taking a fucking fall here. That powder was shit. It was
shit. What? What's going on? Shit. Shit.
What you gonna do with that piece?
You and me are going for a little ride.
Who the hell are you?
You're gonna tell me about Doc Gaston's operation.
This gives the Russians a head start in the man-to-the-moon race.
Can't tell you shit if I'm fucking dead! Folks don't even tell me the fucking time, I swear!
Spill, let's go!
If I knew anything, I'd tell you!
Your time's running out!
We got a fucking ton of shit coming in my boat. I'll tell you where.
Find a new line.
We need help! Personal units be advised. Reports of a hit-and-run incident in the French Ward. Response requested.
So did you fuck her or what?
You serious?
Holy shit!
How's Doc Gaston running?
There's a man with a gun. I need help.
Boss's bagmen aren't collecting. They always take the money back to a stash house somewhere.
You work for me now.
All units, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrols.
You give me a new ride in the French Ward.
On a lot. Just getting her warmed up.
Four wheels and an engine.
That's a big help.
You belong to me.
Department, report
of a hit and run incident in the French Ward. Response requested. All units, negative visual on suspect. Begin search.
Burke says you can help me keep the cops mellow. That true?
Of course it is. I'm just getting a feel for how they do things around this precinct. But I can still make things happen.
Is that a gun?
Huh?
Put him in the ground! Let's kill our fucking creep! Asshole's out of ammo!
What happens next, motherfucker? Think you know?
Hearing about a lot of dead dealers, the ones that are finally talking, saying Doc Gaston's in the system beneath the Big Mouth Jazz Club.
You're not gonna try to convince me to let you arrest him, are you?
If I wanted to arrest him, I wouldn't have let you be a part of this. Justice might be blind, but it shouldn't be stupid, too. Go do whatever it is you're gonna do.
Sure thing, detective.
You lured out that hippie asshole Gaston. You gonna go deal with him?
Dickweed. God. Makes him racist, man. It's not my choice.
Coming through.
Hello, miss.
Sorry.
What's this asshole want?
Let's keep everyone smart. When they were growing up,
what?
Here from all over. Horn
what?
And drinking well. And committing
the
boys.
Asshole with a gun!
Not a sign of it.
Oh, my fault.
Run! I can't believe you got in here.
For you, baby.
It was exhausting.
Some shit back out of my tires a couple nights.
He just got shot!
Everybody get!
Did he just shoot him?
I threw a rock last night. This might be the end for me.
Take survivor hand, yeah. Son's hand sacrifice for the golden dawn.
Up at the cannery. Give me my own skin.
Your favorite. And toss it high.
Get out of here!
To shatter into a star sign. The warm sighs of grandparents.
You know, Jackie, I consider myself a mentor, a teacher, like Jesus.
Got nowhere to go!
Come get me, Paul!
Get your man over to the French ward. I need backup to lock this down.
Okay, but promises were made. And I expect you to live up to them.
Open season on there.
There's our pick! There he is! Let's go!
I'm of two minds when it comes to Lincoln's legacy. On the one hand, he was a brutal criminal who killed God knows how many people. A new breed of mobster, a prototype for criminals to come. Someone like that doesn't deserve the position history has afforded him. He should be forgotten, erased. But I also understand that Lincoln had a significant impact on the Italian mob in this city. He did what the Bureau wouldn't or couldn't do. He finished them.
And the murder of Dr. King is in fact proof of that. We must continue his legacy or risk allowing his death to be in vain.
Thank you.
a name for your judge. Cornelius Holden. He just made a call to Lou.
I get worked up. I barely avoided that lunatic, Lou. They're not paying me enough. I'm gonna stop you right there, Cornelius. Never know who might be listening in. You need to get this shit under control here. Because until you do, your brother's case isn't going anywhere. There's no call for that kind of talk. I'll send over a car, a couple of my best men. They'll see to it that you're kept safe.
Cornelius is 60. The dipshits of this state first elected him to the Fifth Circuit in 1951. There's something else you should know. Those two men are Lamont Harris and Trey McCall. They were killed by a man named Hollis Dupree.
Yeah, I heard he gunned them down when they showed up to his house asking for help.
Hollis claims it was in self-defense, said he thought they were there to kill him. Cornelius is the judge that's presiding over the trial.
So killing him might kick up a lot of noise.
Cornelius is an entitled southern asshole. Killing him is going to do a lot more than kick up some noise. Hopefully, it'll send a message that is long past the time that those cocksuckers went extinct. That's the car down there that Lou was talking about.
That thing armored?
I pulled the work order for it. It's a complete custom job. Tough as hell. It'll take a pounding, but it won't be impossible. Cornelius is scheduled to leave any time now, so this is your window.
You follow a set route?
Not since the trial started, but he still makes a stop or two on the way home. So, you can either hit him then, or go after him when he's driving around.
All right.
And watch out for the cops. And watch out for the cops.
Downtown.
Made your way now.
What's up? And watch out for the cops.
I need a supply run out to the French ward.
Be out directly.
There's our tape!
I need some of my party favors. You know where to go, son. Can't read this nonsense right now. Poor son of a bitch.
Fucking entitled prick.
You want to hear Marcano tear Uncle Lou a new one?
Lou Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden, is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now, to keep holding him one goddamn piece to left of that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now, listen here. I know a guy, a state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. getting laid, all that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down to shitter. We're fucked. All of us.
I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou, get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacob is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou and was basically the Santa Claus of the French ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
Thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
Ready to go when you are.
Assume you already mapped out where the riverboat's gonna go.
Lou's pretty fastidious about that kind of thing. Always follows the same path when he goes cruising through the bayou. Doesn't want anything to happen to his beloved Delphine.
Gonna be the least of his problems. You recon the area?
There's an old coal dumper that they have to sail past. I've already got it rigged to blow. You just need to connect the primer cord to each block and then set it off. Detonator's down by your feet.
All right.
Isolate and kill. Lincoln Clay's specialty. What's wrong? Yeah, it's the boat thing, isn't it?
Not saying it is, not saying it ain't.
You need to get over it. You were on, what, 40, 45 PBRs in country?
52. That's not the point. You don't know what it's like to get onto a boat knowing full well the damn thing's gonna sink? It gets old, man.
Look, you blow the coal dumper. Boom. It hits the boat. Then you jump on board and kill Lou and those other assholes. 50-50, you don't even get wet.
50-50?
40-60, but still. Sun. 30-70 at the worst.
Let's get you upstairs. You all fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
Hey!
I think we tilted a little.
Damn, it hurts!
Jesus Christ!
That's far enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Pick another step and he gets you. You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on!
Listen, I got money. You can have it. All of it. Just don't kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yep. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
State Senator Walter Jacobs was killed this evening in a fiery explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
I understand you supplied the heroin Georgia was selling.
Si, certo.
Never wanted that in my city. Shit like that fucks with people's heads. Makes them crazy. Stupid. Brings down too much heat. Gerben?
No, I do not drink.
Georgie tell you why I wanted to meet?
He said the nigger killed your brother. That you wish to disguise a deal between the two of us?
They found Lou tied to a statue over in the French ward. He was gutted like a goddamn catfish.
I apologize for your loss.
Lou fucked up. It's his own damn fault. Look at here. I'm building a casino across the lake. I had it all set up to get gambling legalized. Now it's all a goddamn mess.
You want my money?
We need to get to the governor, and it ain't gonna be cheap.
I want to hear you say it.
Say what?
That you want my money. Say those words, please.
I want your money.
This is good. I will bring you the money, and in exchange, you will let me sell heroin in your city. And you will not interfere in any way.
Sure. Whatever you want. That's not the only...
You also wish me to kill the nigger. I will do that for you as well. I enjoy killing the niggers.
Jesus Christ.
That's where Sammy's used to be. No one wanted to live there, so they paved it over. Every now and then, something knocks the hell out of this country. Rattles it so hard, isn't much left but the foundation. And as painful as it is, we hope that this time, things are gonna be different. And that when it's time to rebuild, we won't just repeat what we've done in the past. And that maybe justice and peace will finally prevail. Justice and peace are hard, ain't they? Sometimes too hard. So we take the easy way.
Hey there, come on over and sit.
Come on in. This city's gonna learn that their dear old Uncle Lou didn't die out there in the swamps when his riverboat sank. And with Lou dead, Sal's gonna be scrambling to figure out his next move. Meanwhile, we're gonna take control of the plowhouse, the cistern, and all the drinking and fucking in the French ward.
You're starting to give me the impression that I might not be a real important part of this crew.
Twice, Turf came to this table and went someplace that wasn't me. That's not an easy thing for a guy like me to take. But now my guy's got all the action here locked down and ready to go. All you gotta do is say the word, and the money starts rolling in.
The lass is a fighter. You'll get no arguments on that. And she talks a good game, but she hasn't a clue what she's doing. I've run all the vices this city has to offer, probably invented half of them. There's no one better to be running them.
Here's the thing, Lincoln. Getting you boys in here vying for turf is guaranteed to end up a pissing contest. Just easy on everybody if you give me the territory like you did last time.
Trust ain't something that comes easy to me, kid.
But gonna need Vito to run this turf.
How about you quit wasting my goddamn time? No one here has got more know-how than yours truly. If you can't see that, then you can go fuck yourself.
Kiss my ass, you stupid pot-licking donkey.
All right, so if we done, I'm gonna go.
Time to get back at it. Let's clear out.